Hey, you want a drink? I got these cups here for you. Which one do you want? This one? Ugh. I don't know that you want this one. I think you want this one. Yeah. Nope. Man, our lives can be likened to these cups. The thing is, we need to be like a different cup. But with this one right here, Jesus spoke totally against this one, where it's clean on the outside, but absolutely filthy on the inside. Jesus actually said about the Pharisees, Matthew 23, that they were whitewashed tombs. That even though they were outwardly made beautiful, so when people walk by, they just see the beauty of the whitewashed tomb, they were full of dead man's bones. And literally, our lives can be like this. And that if we're doing things just for our benefit, or we're doing nice things or good things, but we have sin and grime in our lives, this is what we're like. It can be like this one, too, where we have been transformed. We've been made pure, but on the outside, we're not doing many good things. We're not displaying the glory of the Lord, and we need to be like a different cup. Jesus said in Matthew 15:8, actually, where he said that the Pharisees' lips glorify me. They honor me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. And like this cup, we don't need to be like either one of these. Ultimately, this one, you're not going to get grime on your hands either, but it's pure on the inside, clean on the inside, and just clean on the outside. And we need to be transformed by the work of Jesus Christ. And even though we have sin, the problem of grime, and Hebrews 12 says we need to cast that off, we can be transformed through the work of Jesus Christ, that his death and his resurrection, he took on our punishment for the sin and the grime in our lives. And as a result, we can take on his righteousness. And so when God looks at us, if we have put our faith in Jesus Christ, he sees purity. Wonderful. It's a beautiful picture there. But hey, we are created unto good works. We needed to display the radiance from the outside. So we're transformed on the inside, and out of love for Jesus, we show his glory by doing good works, doing good things to his glory. Ephesians 2:8-10 illustrates this. The verses read, "For it is grace that you have been saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is the gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast." And again, not of works. But in verse 10 there, it says, "For we are God's workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, that we might walk in them." And the thing is, we love Jesus, and we display it through these good works. And my prayer for you, and my hope for you, is that just like Psalm 24 mentions, who will ascend to the hill of the Lord? It's those who have clean hands and a pure heart. Those who have been purified and redeemed by the Lord. And it's through Jesus Christ that we have ultimate purity, and we can be transformed into being conformed into the image of his Son. And my prayer for you again is that you would love Jesus more, regardless of what season you're in. If you don't know him, come to know him. Love him. Enjoy him. Enjoy his gift, his blessings, and accept that for your life. And if you do know him, love him more, regardless of what it is in your life. If something is keeping you from Jesus, get it out of the way and just love him more and enjoy him more. And guys, I hope that you enjoyed this illustration, and may we be pure inside, transformed by Jesus Christ, and display his glory by doing good works. God bless you.